Thank you. The next piece that we're about to play is a piece that I wrote over a course of a couple of months last summer. The piece is called Dark Carnival, and it was titled this because it's largely inspired by the novel by Stephen King called It, about a nasty clown who preys on the people of Derry, a fictional town in Maine, USA. The piece is in three movements. The first movement is Waltz Consort, or Waltz with Mute. It was largely inspired by the first movement of Bartók's fourth string quartet, which is for strings with mutes. But muted brass and muted strings are rather different. We have a variety of mutes. In the trumpet, and myself in the trombone, we have metal mutes, which have a very bright, tinny sound. And on the tuba and the horn, we have fiber mutes, which have a darker, more closed cushion sound. And the idea of this movement is Pennywise, the clown in It, he uses deception and fools his victims into letting him get close. And so the waltz is basically quite a sinister dance of him deceiving his victims before eventually pouncing on them, and you'll hear exactly when that is. The second movement is a lullaby, but it's not sweet lullaby, it's quite a lonely lullaby. Trying to consider what the cost of one of these, one of Pennywise's attacks might be. It's about loss and grief and loneliness. The final movement is a polka. Once again, Pennywise is doing his dances of deception, but they're not working this time, and each one is changing quicker and quicker, getting more frantic, until eventually he meets his demise. This is Dark Carnival. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is For Rosie by the jazz trombonist Mark Nightingale. He wrote the piece in 2019 for Onyx Brass, a brass quintet in the UK, as part of a suite of pieces which he dedicated to his family. Rosie is his daughter, and this piece takes a lot of jazz influence throughout, with intertwining solo lines and an improvisatory feel throughout the piece. Without further ado, I hope you enjoy For Rosie by Mark Nightingale.
thank the church, St. Giles in the Fields, and the management and organisers for allowing us to perform here. It's been a wonderful opportunity. We'd like to leave you with a final piece called That's a Plenty, written by Lou Pollack. This is a 20th century Dixieland, a jazz tune transcribed for the brass quintet of the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, actually. So it's a great honour to be able to perform this arrangement for you today. Feel free to tap along, snap along, and have a lovely rest of your day.
Thank you.